Up until now, professional football teams would play postseason exhibition games around the country to make money and promote the league. During the 1937 National Football League meeting in Chicago, the owners changed this as a first step to ending all postseason ball games. Essentially, the only teams allowed to travel as far as California for exhibition games would be the two squads playing in the annual playoff game. During these sessions, the owners granted a new franchise to Cleveland, bringing the league size back up to 10 teams. The Cleveland Rams played their first season in the inaugural season of the Second American Football League in 1936. This league folded after the 1937 season. Cleveland was granted the franchise after owner Homer Marshman assured league owners of his team's financial stability. In the 1937 episode of The Starters, the Washington Redskins, led by rookie sensation Sammy Baugh, traveled to Wrigley to take on the Chicago Bears. The Bears, known for their high-powered offense, relied heavily on the ground game of Bronco Nagurski to move the ball and a passing attack for scoring touchdowns. The Redskins, with Baugh leading the league in passing and Cliff Battles on top of the charts in rushing, slaughtered the New York Giants 49-14 in the last game of the season to punch their ticket to the big game. Please relax and enjoy this edition of The Starters.
When you think that you're crazy, you're the victim of the dipsy doodle, but it's not your mind that's hazy.
Attention, ladies and gentlemen, the University of Chicago Band will now perform the Star Spangled Banner. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Introducing the starting players for the Washington Redskins. Left end number 40 from Notre Dame, Wayne Milner. Left tackle number 17 from Washington State, Turk Edwards. Left guard number 21 from Mercer, Les Olson. Center number 39 from Illinois, Eddie Kowal. Right guard number 26 from Ohio State, Jim Karcher. Right tackle number 15 from San Francisco, Jim Barber. Right end number 19 from Texas A&M, Charlie Malone. Quarterback number 35 from Alabama, Riley Smith. Left halfback number 33 from Texas Christian, Sammy Ball. Right halfback number 22 from Southern California, Ernie Pinker. Fullback number 20 from West Virginia Wesley, Cliff Battles. Head coach Ray Flaherty and the rest of the Washington Redskins. Now, introducing the starting players for your Chicago Bears. Left end number 18 from Northwestern, Ed Mansky. Left tackle number 13 from West Virginia, Joe Steidahar. Left guard number 21 from Colgate, Danny Fortman. Center number 24 from Kansas, Frank Bausch. Right guard number 16 from Milliken, George Musso. Right tackle number 82 from Oregon, Del York. Right end number 30 from Northwestern, George Wilson. Quarterback number 33 from Nebraska, Bernie Masterson. Left halfback number 25 from Cincinnati, Ray Moulton. Right halfback number 10 from Minnesota, Jack Manders. Fullback number 3 from Minnesota, Rocco Nagurski. And head coach George Halas and the rest of the Chicago Bears. Your officials for today's game. Referee Bill Halloran from Providence. Umpire Ed Cochran from Chicago. Field judge Tommy Hewitt from Buffalo. Head linesman Bobby Kahn from Chicago. The captains will now meet with the officials at midfield for the coin toss. Washington has won the toss and chosen to receive.
Sammy Baugh threw for an unprecedented 335 yards and 3 touchdowns in leading the Redskins to their first championship, 28-21. It wasn't that the Bears could not score, but more that Chicago just could not stop ball. He threw 33 passes and completed 18 of them, including a 77-yard touchdown to Wayne Milner that tied the game at 21. The 15,000 fans who braved the cold to watch both teams play in basketball shoes on the frozen turf spent their afternoon in complete awe of Sammy Ball. Chicago writers noted that everyone could forget every detail of the game, except Sammy Ball played for Washington. And together, they were champions of the National Football League.
When you think that you're crazy, you're the victim of the dipsy doodle. But it's not your mind that's hazy, it's your tongue that's at fault, not your noodle. You better listen and try to be good, and try to do all the things that you should. The dipsy doodle will get you someday. You'll think you're crazy, the things that you say, like rhythm got I and hot am I. That's the way the dipsy doodle works.